I think there's in your new film, which I've seen, and it's coming out today, I believe, A Touch of Class?
That's right.
There's a scene in it which I thought was terribly good because it's the first time I've ever heard it said on the screen. This is after you've made love for the first time with George Segal. Yeah. But the fact is, I mean, I really don't think it's ever been admitted, has it? I mean, not to my knowledge, that women don't necessarily enjoy it at the same time and in the same way as men.
Right.
Now, this is certainly a bit of progress as far as women are concerned.
Yes, I mean, actually, it's very interesting, you should say, because that, which I found the most interesting part of that scene, which was hastily sort of covered over and we got to the typically American bit. But it is, I mean, it's never said that, in fact, I don't know, it's very curious, this idea, the thing, the line in that scene that used to make me want to puke was where he says, I want to say thank you. The idea, you know, that actually getting into bed with a man is the greatest gift a woman has to offer. Mm. And that, like it or lump it, you know, you fulfilled your part of the bargain just by lying there. And the fact that you may not get anything out of it has nothing to do with it at all. You know, it's all balanced that particular way.
But you see, I think it's almost helpful, that bit of that film, because I honestly think that women have never admitted to the fact that it's taken them a very long time to enjoy sex.
No, I mean, I'm sure not. And also, it's, I mean, not only that, but the whole sort of structure of society is as such to say that, well, you can't ever really enjoy it until you're married.
Mm.
That's the first thing,
that's
you know, that's the great setback. And then, well, if you don't particularly enjoy it, never mind, because think of all the other things you've got to bolster your sagging confidence, you know. Or if it's wrong, if you don't enjoy it, then it's your fault. You know, you're not doing the right things. How you're supposed to know what the right things are is you've been kept in a state of total ignorance and herder until that gold band is slipped onto your finger, I really don't know.
When you did that film, this is a terrible little gawk question, it's just because I think George Segal's very, very nice. The whole film is in fact about an affair, a sudden affair. You go away for a week with him, who is happily married and his children, and you go away, who is divorced, but with children and a job. Now, first of all, of course, as me, seeing the film, I see it all. So I think all the time that you were in Spain with him for a week and you were running into that bedroom and you did make love to him. Now, what, in fact, how do you get involved with somebody like your leading actor when you have to make love with him?
Well, I think, speaking entirely personally, you don't. I mean, if I actually was in love or having an affair with someone and then had to reenact that for a camera, I wouldn't be able to move. I mean, it would be sort of like bringing a camera into your own bedroom and it would be a terrible intrusion of privacy. But you really don't have time, I think, to get to know the person very much. You get to know the character because in a funny way you hardly ever meet each other anyway. You come down onto a set at a god-awful early hour and you rehearse it and then you go away for hours while they light it and then you come back down when it's lit and you rehearse it a couple of times for the camera and then you do it and then you're on to the next scene and that process goes on. So quite often the only conversation you have is scripted dialogue.
Yes.
The week in Spain, actually, it's funny you should say that, we were there for 3 weeks, which were the most horrendous weeks of my life, I think. I mean, I was so bored. We seemed to spend most of our time trailing around golf courses, which is a game that I'm not terribly interested in. And all I had to do was follow a golf ball and George around unending greens in sort of blazing sun. And then I got an upset stomach and it was all ghastly and awful. But I think it would be quite difficult, actually, to sort of create some actual personal relationship with an actor. I mean, you could do it, but I think the performance would suffer.
Well, I can understand then in that case why you can't, because of the little snippet the little and all the technicalities and all the chaps looking at you anyway and seeing the thing. But, I mean, say, for instance, your husband.
Mm.
What does he feel about it?
Well, possibly because he was an actor himself and has been in the theatre and in the business, he always looks at it as though he was a critic, really. And he either likes or dislikes the actual performance. I mean, he doesn't particularly like this performance, but I don't think it would occur to him that there would be more than just sort of an acting relationship, really, because it would be awfully hard, I think, to have one.
Yes, except that you can... What I'm saying is that you can actually, as a person, though... I mean, I know that you didn't really have an affair with George Segal, but the film makes it so real that I'd have thought that somebody like your husband looking at you, kissing, apparently, like you'd kiss him, an actor on the screen, I'd have thought it was quite hard to come to this. I think I'd find it hard
if
my husband...
I don't know if he's... a totally arrogant chauvinist pig.
Sure of you.
But no, I don't think it worries him at all.
And how does your domestic setup work with, you've got a son, age four?
Yeah. Well, it works well in as much as I can. The only thing I never have enough of when I'm working is time, really. So I'm in a fortunate position of being able to buy other people's. And, you know, when you're filming, it falls into a very easy routine. In fact, you sort of leave the house at 6 and you're home again at 8. And that's it. And the sort of middle of the day, you know, is being sort of looked after. I've been very fortunate. There have been no sort of domestic dramas while I've been working. I mean, you know, my son hasn't been suddenly smitten with some terrible disease, and Roy hasn't had an accident or something. So it's all worked very well. And you have your weekends free, usually, when you're filming. You don't in the theatre, of course, but it works all right.
Have you ever had the sort of what's called the traditional guilt feeling of a mother to say, you know,
all
that
the
she's
time,
not there?
All the time. Mm. I mean, I don't think you ever get rid of that. I mean, I would hope that for future generations, if sort of women's liberation on its more serious level actually takes off, they won't be saddled with this sort of terrible feeling of that you're doing some sort of secret damage. You know, I mean, a little knowledge is a dangerous thing, and the realisation that the first 4 years of their life form most of their intelligence, and that what is most important to them is a secure and loving home relationship. I think the idea that you might be cracking that at the edges and turning him into sort of paranoid neurotics is a terrible sort of burden.
Are you a bad-tempered lady?
Not often, no. I get irritable occasionally, but I've got such a foul, foul temper when I lose it that I don't lose it often.
A foul, foul temper, in fact, ends the... not ends it, but in A Touch of Class, there is this fantastic scene.
Yes.
And so we are going to say goodbye to viewers now.